Vestibular system processes the sensory information that help us to maintain our gaze, posture, and head movement with respect to gravity. In this video, I am going to introduce what is vestibular system, what are its function, and the one component of the vestibular system, that is the otolith organ. Everyone, welcome back to HM Learnings. I am Harshita, the creator of HM Learnings, where students come to clear their concept and to get the study material. Make sure that you have subscribed my channel. You can also follow HM Learnings on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And in this video, we are going to talk about the vestibular system, and I'm going to introduce the vestibular system and its function. And in the upcoming videos, we are going to talk about the rest of the components of the vestibular system, which are the semicircular canals and how the information is going to be processed in the vestibular nuclei and as well as the vestibular ocular reflex. So with this, we can start this video. So first of all, as I said, that you need to know that what is vestibular system. So basically, people tend to think that whenever we talk about the vestibular system, it's just the inner ear structures, which are the semicircular canals and the otolith organs. But it is not like that. The vestibular system has actually two portions. It has a peripheral portion and it has a central portion. So peripheral portion actually includes the inner ear structures, which are actually going to be act as a inputs. They are going to sense the head movement with respect to gravity, and then they are going to code the information in the form of the action potential, which is going to travel via the way of the vestibular nerve, which is the division of the vestibular ocular nerve, and it goes to the brainstem. So in the brainstem, we are having the central portion of the vestibular system, which is the vestibular nuclei. So this vestibular nuclei receives the information from the vestibular apparatus, that is a peripheral portion of the vestibular system, as well as from the other regions, like it is going to receive the visual inputs also, somatosensory inputs also, from the cerebellum also it is going to receive the inputs, and it is going to integrate all this information and send its projection to the brainstem, cerebellum, and the oculomotor nuclei to control our posture, our orientation of the head, and the gaze with respect to movement. So this is actually the whole of the vestibular system, and we are going to complete this vestibular system in the parts. So this is part one, which is going to talk about the peripheral portion of vestibular system and particularly about the otolith organs. So what is the function of the vestibular system and why it is important? Why it is considered one of the important senses? It is also called as a sixth sense. So why it is important? So the amazing thing you can say about the vestibular system is that it is even present in the lower animals, in the invertebrates also, and there the function is also the same as the vestibular system has a function in our body. So the function is that it acts as a guidance system. So guidance system, it is going to actually act and as well as detecting, interpreting our motion. So there could be two types of motion. They could be linear motion and they could be rotational motion. So both these types of the motion are being detected by this vestibular system. So linear motion as well as a rotational motion. So the thing is that from which body part it is going to detect the motion, that is from the head. And with respect to what? With respect to gravity, because we know that the most prevalent force on the earth is a gravity, and gravity is nothing but the force on force with its vertical component or the single component, which is being orienting towards the central core, towards the core of the planet. Okay, so with respect to gravity, each and every movement of our body is decided. Okay, so that is why it is going to detect our motion of the head with respect to gravity. So the vestibular system is actually coding for the acceleration of the head movement, the velocity of the head movement, the positional information of the head. So right now, if your head is upright, even then the vestibular system, the vestibular apparatus in the inner ear is going to code for the position of the head. Now if you are going to turn your head towards the left, here you have turned the head, so what is the acceleration, okay, and with what velocity you have turned the head, and at what position is the head is. So all these information is going to be coded by the vestibular system. So now you can understand that why it is called as a sixth sense and why it is considered as a sensory system, as a part of a sensory system. It is going to provide you the spatial orientation. Okay, so you know that where your head is in the space. It is going to stabilize the gaze, head and posture during the movement, because as we have already seen, that vestibular nuclei is going to receive the inputs from many areas and going to send the inputs to those areas which are concerned with controlling the posture, gaze and the orientation of the head. And all these things need to be maintained when we are doing any movement, and all these movements are happening with respect to the gravity. So every change in our head movement is going to be detected related to the gravity. Okay, so I hope that you are clear with the function of the vestibular system, and now you have understood the importance of this system. So now we can actually start with the peripheral vestibular apparatus, and that we have otolith organs and the semicircular canals. So this is basically in the inner ear, and you can see in this diagram utricle and saccule and the three semicircular canals, the anterior vertical, posterior vertical and the horizontal one. So we are going to discuss in today's video about the otolith organs. One by one we are going to discuss about. First we are discussing about the utricle and then the saccule. So basically their function is almost the same, only thing that their orientation is different. So the utricle is actually horizontally placed in the inner ear. So here you can see that this is the, just like we have seen in the cochlea, the structure is more or less the same here also. So we have seen the organ of Peutz in the cochlea. So in that we have seen that there are hair cells and the supporting cells. Okay, just like here the macula is there. This is called as a macula, which is the sensory neuroepithelium containing the hair cells, and in between the hair cells there are supporting cells. Okay, so from the hair cell, from the basal end of the hair cells, we have the efferent axon, which is actually the vestibular nerve. From the apical part, the hair bundles are projecting into the membrane, which is called as a otolithic membrane. So this otolithic membrane has a gelatinous layer, in that this hair bundles are projecting, and above this layer there are certain crystals which are actually the calcium carbonate crystals which are embedded in this layer. Okay, these are called as a otoconia. So because of these otoconia in the otolithic membrane, the mass of this membrane becomes more than the surrounding structures and the lymph. Okay, so we are going to see the importance of this when we are going to talk about that how those otolith organs function. So in that we are going to talk about the importance of the relative high mass of this otolithic membrane. Okay, now we have another component here which is not being there in the semicircular canals, and which is not there in, even not there in the cochlea. This is called as a striola. So striola is basically a part, you can say this is a striola. This part is a striola, and you can see that the orientation of the hair cell is actually reversed here. So here the kinocilium, which is the tallest one, which is the tallest kinocilia, is actually towards the, if I say this is right and this is, so it is actually towards the right side. But here you can see that now this kinocilium is actually towards the left. So you can see that on the either side of this triola, there are hair bundles which has the opposite polarity. And this is called as a morphological polarization. Okay. So this diagram is showing the same thing, that this is a striola, which is a lesion in the utricle, which is actually marking, dividing the two regions which have the opposite polarity. So this arrow is showing the position of the kinocilium, that where does this kinocilium is actually pointing. So if I draw, this is a striola, okay, these are the hair cells. On either side we have the hair cells. So what you can see that here the kinocilium is towards the striola, okay, and in all this the kinocilium is towards the striola, but here the kinocilium is again towards the striola only. Okay, but you can see that the direction is reversed. So what happens that when a stimulus is coming, so if the stimulus is coming in this direction, okay, we are going to discuss it again when we talk about the function. So when the stimulus is coming in this direction, that is towards the left, what happens is that what happens is that this group of hair cells will be going to be depolarized, because here the bending of the hair cell is towards the kinoscilium, okay? But this group of hair cells will going to be hyperpolarized, because here the bending of the cell hair cells or the stereocilia is towards the kinoscilium. Sorry, it's away from the kinoscilium, sorry. Okay, so here it is towards the kinoscilium, here it is away from the kinoscilium. So here will be the hyperpolarization and here will be the depolarization. So you can see that towards in this for the same stimulus, what is happening, that one set of the hair cells are going to be hyperpolarized and one set of the hair cells are going to be depolarized. And this is going to help you in what? This is actually helping the otolith organs in actually coding the direction in which the head is moving. Okay, and as well as because of this property, because of this arrangement of the hair cells, because of this arrangement, because of this morphological polarization, the utricle and the saccule, they can actually code for the movement of the head in any plane. Okay, now we can see the next type of the otolith organ, which is the saccule. So here you can see that the orientation is different. In the case of the utricle, it is actually along the horizontal plane. Now it is actually along the vertical plane. So the hair cells are arranged like this. Okay, in the utricle it was like this, in the horizontal plane. Okay, again the same thing, you have a macula and the hairs, you can the stereocilia are embedded in the gelatinous layer, and on that you have a otoconia which is embedded in that otolithic membrane, which is going to increase the mass of this membrane. Now here also the striola concept is being there. So what is happening, if this is the striola, so you can see that in this case the kinocilium is pointing away from the striola. So here if I draw the hair cell, this is the kinocilium which is pointing away from the striola. Okay, so here again you can see that what happens if a stimulus is coming in this direction. Okay, so if the stimulus is coming in this direction, this group of cells will be hyperpolarized and this group of cells will be depolarized. So again the same thing is going to happen. So with respect to the stimulus, one particular stimulus, one set of the cells will be get hyperpolarized, one set of the cells will be get depolarized, and that is how it is going to code for the direction of the stimulus, as well as that is how these otolith organs can code for the linear acceleration and the movement and the head tilt in any plane. Okay, so after this we can actually go, so this is just the same thing, and yeah, so here we can actually understand that what is the function of the otolith organs. So they are going to detect the linear acceleration during the head tilt and the translational motion. So translation motion means that when you are changing the position, if you are here and you are going from A to B, this is a translational motion, but in a linear, okay, linear means along a straight line, okay, not a rotational movement. And head tilt is I hope that you can understand from this diagram. So this is the head tilt, you're tilting the head backward and you're tilting the head forward. So this is called as a head tilt. So both these type of movements are detected by the otolith organs. And saccule, because it has which type of arrangement, arrangement, in that you have a vertical alignment. Okay, so in that case we know that the saccule is arranged like this. So this is a vertical alignment. Okay, so vertical alignment means it is going to sense the vertical acceleration and deacceleration. So this is acceleration, vertical acceleration and deacceleration. Okay, and saccules are arranged like this, so it is going to sense the horizontal acceleration towards right or towards left. Okay, as well as sideward tilts. So sideward tilts means towards the right or towards the left. Okay, so I hope you understand the function of otolith organs. So they are going to actually sense the linear motion, not the rotational motion. Rotational motion is by the semicircular canals. And they are going to sense the head tilts also. So in the case of the sacral, it is a forward and the backward head tilt. In the case of the utricle, it is actually the sideways, right and the left. So now how basically these organs are going to work? So here we are actually discussing the utricle only, okay? But the same thing is going to be applied on the sacral as such. So this is the upright position. In the upright position also, the vestibular nerve fibers are going to fire at the resting position also, which is going to code that the head is in upright position, because as I said that the vestibular system is also going to code for the position, okay? So it is going to code for the position even at the upright position, okay? Upright position of the head. Now what happens when there is a head tilt? So when the head is tilting, what is going to happen? That because of gravity, what is going to happen that, and we know that this area, this otoconia, which has been embedded in the otolytic membrane, is having a greater mass than the surrounding limbs, surrounding endolymph and the structures, and this is actually going to push, or you can, it is actually going to pull the otolytic membrane towards the gravity. So if you are tilting the head towards backward, the otolytic membrane is also tilting backwards, but the hair cells, they are not tilting. Because of that, there is a shear force which is being generated between the otolytic membrane and the hair bundle. And that is how they will be bending of the hair bundle towards or away from the kinocelium, depending upon the polarization of that hair bundle, and there will be a generation of the receptor potential. Okay, and that is how the utricle is going to work when the backward head tilt is happening. Now what happens when a forward tilt is happening? So opposite is going to happen here. Because the head is tilting forward, because of the gravity, the greater mass of the otoconia or the otolytic membrane is going to pull the membrane in the forward direction. This is going to generate the shear force between the hair bundle and the otolytic membrane, which is going to cause the bending of the hair bundle towards the kinocelium or away from the kinocelium, and will cause the generation of the receptor potential. Okay, so this is for the head tilt. Now what happens when there's a transient motion, or basically the translational motion, when the person is moving from one position to another position? So the person is moving, if the person is moving forward, what is going to happen that as a person is moving, and we know that the otolytic membrane has a greater mass, because of its greater mass, it lags behind the head, it lags behind the hair bundles, okay? And that is why there is going to be again the shear force which is being generated between the otolytic membrane and the hair bundles, which is going to push the hair bundle away or towards the kinocelium, depending upon its organization, and there will be generation of the receptor potential. In deacceleration, that means in the opposite direction, if it is moving, in that case what happens again, the hair bundles are moving, but because of the greater mass, the otolytic membrane lags behind, okay, which is again going to cause a shear force between the hair bundle and the otolytic membrane, and hence there will be generation of the receptor potential. So this is how this otolytic organs are going to work. This is the head tilt. Gravity will cause a membrane to shift related to the macula in the same direction as the head tilt is happening. It is going to cause a shear force between the membrane and the macula, cause the displacement of the hair bundle and the generation of the receptor potential. Then the same thing here also, head moves ahead due to the greater relative mass of otolytic membrane. It lags behind the macula, displacement of hair bundle, and there will be generation of the receptor potential. Okay, so we have seen here that how with respect to the, when the motion is happening, the otolytic organs are going to code. So they are going to code for the position as well as for the velocity as well as for the acceleration. And they are also going to, and in this example actually they are showing you, this is actually the experimental work, and in this experiment what they have done is that they actually took a monkey and they actually make the monkey sit on a chair. And then they tilt the chair in order to see that how the vestibular nerve is going to fire in response to the tilting of the chair. So we know that vestibular nerve is actually the nerve which is receiving all its, which is actually innervating the hair cell. So if the vestibular nerve is firing, that means there must be some activity in the hair bundle, in the hair cell, then only the vestibular nerve is firing. So how that firing is actually changing with response to the head tilt, okay? So this is actually showing you the stimulus. So what happens, initially the chair is at rest, okay, and the monkey is there on the chair, okay? So now you tilt the chair, okay, you are slowly tilting the chair and you have maintained the tilt of the chair for a certain period, and then you slowly take that chair back to the, its 0 degree, okay? So what happens with respect to this change in the tilting of the chair, okay? So now as the chair is tilting, what happens, the monkey head is also tilting. So what is happening with respect to the tilting of the head? So now this is actually showing, the y-axis is showing the spikes per second. Spikes per second in what? In the vestibular nerve axon, okay? And with respect to the time. So you can see here, as I said already, that they are going to code even for the position. So this is the resting position, or the position at which the head is upright. So at that time also, you can see about 40 spikes per second are happening. That means the hair bundle, the hair cells are even responsible, are even coding for the position of the head. Now what happens when you have applied the tilt? So you have tilt the chair and it is going to increase the rate. The rate of firing is increasing. The discharges are increasing. And as you maintain that tilt, the firing is also maintained. Okay, this is how it is also, again, it is going to code for the position. Okay, here it is coding for the change in the position. Okay, that is the velocity, degree of the tilt, you can say. Okay, because here tilting is happening in the angular way. So now, or you can say centimeter per second mein the tilting is happening. Now after this, when you actually remove the tilt, okay, so what happens is decrease in the firing. Okay, so again it is going to code for the change in the position. Okay, and then this resting firing is there because now the head is upright, and that is also need to be coded. Okay, now what happens when now you have changed the direction of the tilt? Earlier, suppose you are tilting the chair in the right direction, now you are tilting the chair in the left direction. So what is going to happen now? So now you can see that when the tilting is happening, there is decrease in the firing. So this is showing that, this is actually a form of coding, that earlier it was the tilting of the chair in the right direction, that's why this neuron is has shown the increase in the firing. Now because the tilting is happening in the opposite direction, and this neuron codes for the direction in the it this neuron actually codes more firing for the right direction. That is why when the tilt is in left direction, the number of spikes is decreased in this case. Okay, so that is how this otolith organ or the vestibular system overall codes for the position, the velocity of the change, the change, or you can say change of the position, that is the velocity, as well as for the rate of change of the position, that is the acceleration. So all these are going to be coded by the vestibular system. Okay, so with this we are at the end of this video, and in the upcoming video we are going to talk about the semicircular canal. This is actually a complicated topic, so if you have any doubt, you can comment in the comment section. Yeah, comment on your suggestions for the upcoming video as well. It will help me to decide what should I post next on my channel. If you like this video, please like, share and comment, and please subscribe to HM Learning. Till then, keep learning.